Hey everyone, my name is Gamer Corey, and welcome back to another Red Dead Online video. Now, in today's video, I do want to go over what I believe are the best gold opportunities of making gold here in Red Dead Online are, and these are going to be my top 10 ways of earning gold. Actually, is there even 10 different ways of earning gold in Red Dead Online right now? That would be no. But actually, these will be my top three go-to ways of making gold here in Red Dead Online. And there is one that is significantly better than all of the rest. And you're about to find out exactly what it is. And I'm actually going to give you guys a couple different bonus activities just in case maybe the other options aren't something that you're really into. But I'll give you guys a couple other things that you will be able to generate a decent amount of gold without really participating in PvP type action. But anyway, without further ado, let's go ahead and get right into the video right now. Now, coming in at number three is going to be PvP, or honestly any of the showdown series or any of the showdown modes. Now, this could be the shootout series, it could be the takeover series, it could be the elimination, it really doesn't matter. This also will include any of the horse racing that you guys might want to take and be a part of. Now, you are always going to generate 0.16 gold bars from any of the showdown modes. I'm actually going to show you guys three quick very ends of each of the matches to show you guys that I had different amount of kills, different amount of deaths, and I was always getting 0.16 gold for each of the showdowns that I was actually a part of. Now, there is one requirement that is needed. Number one, you do have to make sure that you guys finish the actual series and not leave during the actual showdown mode. Otherwise, you're just going to forego any of the gold experience and also any of the money that you could have made from participating in any of the showdown modes. Now, the other requirement is making sure that you guys try to get in there from the very, very beginning if possible. And by that, I do mean that if you are halfway through a match and you get put into a showdown mode, it is possible that you might not get all or even a portion of the gold of the 0.16 that I was mentioning earlier. But I gave you guys an opportunity for a couple other ones better. Now, the main reason that I had to put this at number three is because a lot of players keep telling me that they don't want anything to do with PvP. So there are two other opportunities, in my opinion, that are better than showdown mode. So let's go ahead and move on to those right now. Now, coming in at number two is going to be the Bounty Hunter role. Now, this is a role and it does require you to purchase the bounty license before you can participate in doing any of the bounty boards and making the extra gold that you're seeing here on the screen. The week that as I'm recording this video, it has been discounted to 10 gold bars, but it is normally 15 gold bars, and I definitely recommend that you guys go ahead and purchase this role as soon as you possibly can, along with other roles, because it will help you ultimately make more money, gold, and XP, especially over time. Now, there is a lot of fluctuation going on here with the amount of gold that you can earn, so I'm going to try to break this down the best that I possibly can. As you can see on the screen right now in front of you, I made 0.08 gold bars, but that's basically doing a bounty hunting mission as fast as I possibly could. Now, the next one, I actually did a different one, and I'm still going to get 0.08. You're going to see that here in just a second. And I went from a hard one, the first one, down to an easy one for this one, and I got paid the exact same. So just because it's a $3 sign bounty, it might not necessarily pay out any more gold than the other opportunities. Now, you might make a little extra money, more money, but it's not always guaranteed. So I'm going to go over the ways of actually generating more gold from doing these. Number one is to whatever you start this mission at, as soon as you find the person that you need to bring in your bounty that you're bringing in, 50% of that time you would shave off. So if it says 9 minutes, then bring them in after 4.5 minutes. If it's 10 minutes, it's 5 minutes. Whatever that 50% mark is, you're going to get a little extra gold. And that can range from anywhere from, well, 0.08 to 0.32 gold bars, which is pretty amazing. Now, this one, because I did wait a little bit of extra time, and it's not a ton of time, it's usually less than 5 minutes that you truly have to wait. a majority of the time, I only made 0.16. However, doing it for 5 minutes versus the showdown at 8 minutes, you're saving 3 minutes. Now, granted, you are having to go and maybe sometimes find the bounty. There are some variables with it. But overall, if you don't like PvP, this is definitely a really good option to generate anywhere between 0.08 and 0.32 gold bars from just doing normal activities. So let's go ahead and move on. Now, before we actually get into number one, I just want to go over a couple of honorable mentions for generating gold. Now, the first one that we're doing here is any of the treasure maps that you guys obtain. Make sure that you guys are doing them as soon as you get them, and you can make a ton of gold. You saw that I made almost 1.5 gold bars from a treasure map. Now, also keep in mind that these are completely variable and they have a big range. Typically, it's anywhere between 0.5 and 1.5 gold bars. I've seen them a little bit lower and a little bit higher, but for the most part, it's 0.5 to 1.5 for the gold bar. I can't remember exactly what this next one was here, but I think it was like right around 1.5 gold bars as well. But you can only carry about 50 treasure maps in total on you. Now, these include the ones that are in your satchel and also at the post office. So that means if you have over 50, every time that you get 5 ranks, you should be getting a free treasure map. And if you have more than 50 treasure maps, there is a good chance that you're not going to get them for free. So use them as soon as you get them, so that way you guys can earn more gold. Otherwise, if you're not using them, you're actually missing out on gold and money, as free as an opportunity can be. Now, coming in as another honorable mention will be doing stranger missions. Now, there's a couple different ways that you guys can do this. The first one that you guys are seeing here on the screen is basically letting the timer run down to under 30 seconds and then going ahead and delivering it. Now, with this one, I did have to wait about 14 minutes from actually obtaining this wagon, but I do end up actually earning 0.32 gold bars, which is actually pretty decent. So if you have a little bit of time, or maybe you need to, you know, go and do something while you wait for that timer to run down, you can definitely take advantage of that. But if you don't really want to participate in Bounty Hunter or some of the PvP ones, this is another good way of earning some extra gold. And then this one right here was 0.16 gold bars for just delivering that wagon, and it took less than about 5 minutes to complete. So not too bad. Now, coming in at number one is going to be daily challenges. Daily challenges, in my honest opinion, are the best opportunity of generating gold here in Red Dead Online. Now, each and every single day, just in case you guys are wondering, I do go over all the daily challenges in extensive detail so that you guys can earn as much gold as possible. You can earn up to 11 gold bars every single day, and that's just from completing the daily challenges. Now, if any of the daily challenges are basically involve any type of PvP or horse races or free roam events like this bottom one right here, that is all additional opportunities of generating even that much more gold. And actually, if there's anything that's really PvP related, or sometimes even the stranger missions that are included in here, you can earn over 12 gold bars every single day from just doing the daily challenges. Like I said earlier, there are a couple different requirements that are needed in order to make sure that you guys can earn 11 gold bars right off the bat every single day, and I'm going to go over those right now for you guys. Number one, you're going to have a daily challenge streak of completing at least one daily challenge from any of the ones that are available here or of the daily role challenges. So the daily general challenges is what everybody's going to have access to. And then the daily role challenges are going to basically be if anybody has purchased a specific role, you can have anywhere from 1 to 3 daily challenges once you purchase that. And it's all depending on what your current role rank is within that role. So when you first purchase a role, you're going to have access to just one extra daily challenge. When you get to rank 5, you'll have access to 2. And then once you get to rank 10, you'll have access to 3 daily challenges within that role each and every single day. Now, my daily role challenges might be a little bit different than what your guys's are, because it all is dependent on what rank you are. So if you're a lower rank, they're not quite the same. That's the reason why, because I am a rank 20 in each of my roles, And once you guys get up to that rank 20, then they will be the exact same for you. But if you guys have any questions regarding any of those, like I said, I do have a daily challenge breakdown video each and every single day. I definitely recommend that you guys go ahead and check that out. It's usually released about 40 minutes after or so after the daily challenges do change over. And at the same time when Madman Azar actually has moved locations. So it is a great opportunity to participate in my videos and get as much information as you possibly can in order to complete as many of the daily challenges as possible. 0.5 gold opportunities each and every single day, and then you can get that 2.5 applied to the daily general. So you can get 5 daily gold bars from doing the daily general challenges and then 6 gold bars from the daily rule challenges. And you can see that I have completed 9 of my daily challenges so far. That's 4.5 gold bars, and that's roughly about how much I actually get each and every single day from doing the daily challenges. And a majority of these I actually do while I've letting my video render and upload to YouTube, and then after that, for the most part, I'm done doing the daily challenges for the entire day, and then I re-log back on right before the daily challenges switch over and Madman Azar moves. And then I repeat that entire process every day. That's one way that I've actually not become extremely bored and burnt out of Red Dead Online. And that's one of the reasons why I'm not necessarily streaming Red Dead Online any longer. So these are the best way of earning gold. You can't, for anything else to actually get 11 gold bars or up to 11 gold bars, even if you got that 4.5 gold bars, it would take you a few hours even in some of the PvP or showdown modes or other methods that I've given inside of this video to get to that. The next closest one would be treasure maps, but it's completely dependent on luck and complete randomness if you're actually going to obtain one from looting those NPCs. So this is honestly my best way of earning gold. Honestly, I do hope that you guys enjoyed the video. If you guys did enjoy the video in any way, then don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe down below. It would help me out a lot and is greatly appreciated. But until next time, YouTube, you guys keep doing what you're doing because you're already doing it. And you guys, stay gaming.